say hello to the new Insta360 One RS. It's a very cool little action camera that allows you to switch between this wide-angle GoPro-style lens and this 360 lens in a matter of seconds to get some incredible footage of your rides. It's essentially two cameras in one, but yes, it does look exactly like its predecessor. In fact, I sometimes pick up the wrong camera by mistake. However, there is a very good reason for this, and that reason is exactly why I'm such a big advocate for this idea. The original Insta360 One R gave the typical action camera design a rethink. Instead of buying a $500 GoPro and a $500 360 camera, it meant you could have both in one camera for around the same-ish $500. Because it's basically a mullet camera. Business in the front with the wide-angle lens on, and then party in the back when the 360 lens is on. And that was not even the best part. Because it had this modular design, it meant you could keep your core module and battery and simply upgrade your lenses when Insta360 bought out better ones. Exactly like a professional camera.
And to some extent, they played around with that. In the last 2 years, they tried the boosted battery for longer run times, and then they also tried this Leica lens for better photos, or something not entirely bike-related like that.
But the concept was revolutionary. They could simply upgrade the core module to have more processing power, or you could suddenly get better looking videos for the price of just a lens and not a whole new camera.
Which is why I was about 90% sure that this would be the last time we ever saw this concept again. Because if we didn't buy a new camera every year, then how would they make money?
But luckily, I was wrong. Because they seem to have found a way to compromise with us. Because this new camera has a 21% bigger battery. However, it's a battery that is interchangeable with the original camera. There's a new boost lens that's also interchangeable with the original one, and boasts more than just a new red stripe. It's now 48 megapixels, so you can crop the hell out of photos without completely destroying them. Then there's an upgraded core, with a more powerful chip to get better stabilization and better images out of your new or old lenses. However, the 360 lens is unchanged from before. Which tells us that the 360 side of this camera was never the problem.
So, there's a whole new camera for you to buy if you don't already have one. Or you could just upgrade your existing one at your own pace if you want more megapixels or processing power. It really is the perfect setup, but do the changes warrant the upgrade? And if so, which pieces?
The important thing to remember is that the original One R was a good camera to start with, and I got some very memorable footage of my R1 with it. However, it did have three main flaws. Audio that sounds like this, which doesn't do any bike justice. Motor vlogging capabilities that sound like this.
Yamahas are faster than Kawasaki's. I know, controversial.
And the wide-angle lens that wasn't very wide, at least not when compared to a GoPro, resulting in less immersive POV shots.
So I suppose that it's not a coincidence then that all of these problems relate to either the wide-angle lens or the core module, the only big changes made to the new camera. So I guess all we really need to know then is whether these problems have been fixed or not to find out whether it's worth bikers upgrading.
The new boost lens supposedly has a 0.4mm wider focal length, so I was hopeful. I mounted the old Insta360 on my chin and sat on my bike. I then repeated the exact same riding position with the new RS and then followed by my GoPro Hero 7 to see how they all stacked up against each other. And to be honest, that 0.4 of a millimeter is tough to see, even when side by side. It looks plenty wide enough and is definitely perfectly fine to ride with, but when compared to a GoPro, you realize what it's missing. Audio has been a big challenge for Insta360, but I'm relieved to say that it seems better than ever. It used to try to switch between microphones to get the best sounding one, but often just resulted in sounds randomly getting louder, or sounding like it was underwater. It now seems more consistent, and I can actually enjoy the sound of my bike with this camera. Of course, it still struggles with wind noise, just like every other camera does, but you could actually use this audio now. You tell me.
So now what you're listening to is a lapel microphone inside of my helmet, plugged into the side of the Insta360 ONE RS with their new mic adapter. So this is the setup that I would typically use to record all of my motovlog scenes, but usually I'd be using a GoPro because that is what they're very good at. And typically Insta360 is terrible at it. So I really hope that this will sound better.
Immediately, there's an extra step with the Insta360. Because as you plug a mic in it, it prompts you to set your audio levels on the left of the screen. And I ended up using the lowest setting possible, because even just the sounds around me were peaking the audio levels.
How did that sound? Decent? Sounded decent from my point of view. And now you're listening to the exact same mic setup, but this time it is plugged into my GoPro Hero 7. It also requires a mic setup. It's using GoPro's notoriously oversized and overpriced mic adapter, except that you can't critique it too much because at the end of the day, it just works. There are no extra steps like the Insta360 so far. You can obviously manually adjust your audio levels, but usually there's no need. You just plug your microphone in and it automatically does what needs to be done to make it sound perfect. But here is the real test.
So despite the fact that the Insta360 does sound more muffled with less clarity than the GoPro, it is significantly better than it was previously. And the other thing you should always remember about Insta360 is that the camera will be different in a year's time to how it is now, because they are always working on firmware updates to try and improve different aspects of the camera. It seems to me like they've got the basics down and it just needs tinkering, but with that being said, never buy anything based on promised updates, but rather based on how it is currently.
So two out of three issues have been improved, which does sound promising. But don't forget that what Insta360 are best at, and what they care about the most, is in their name, 360. This is where they shine. Why waste time trying to catch GoPro in the wide-angle game when you're already leading the 360 game? The RS boasts all the incredible 360 features as their X2. It automatically gets rid of the pole you mount it to, making it look like there is a highly skilled cameraman following you around while always managing to keep out of the shot. It has incredible stabilization, keeping the horizon level no matter what, and ironing out any bumps you find along your ride. And an app packed full of more features than you'll probably ever use, like bullet time, auto subject tracking, using your phone as a viewfinder to save where the camera is looking, and auto edits that can swing from awesome to questionable. There's also a new case that is less finicky to use. The old one used to hook on the lens in some situations, which has been fixed with the new side-loading case. The buttons are now flush with the case rather than indented, making finding the record button less like a treasure hunt while wearing motorbike gloves. And of course, all the benefits of shooting in 360 still apply, because it sees everything. You can create awesome sweeping movements to never miss any of the action. You can get multiple camera angles from one mounting location and one clip. And if you want to know how to do any of this, I have quite a few videos about 360 cameras on my channel.
So, it's two cameras for the price of one-ish. They fixed the majority of issues that plagued the first camera, and it's got all the features that make them the best 360 camera on offer. And yet, not everyone should buy one. It is the perfect camera for some people, but not everyone. If you have the first generation One R and frequently use the wide-angle lens, then I would recommend upgrading to the boost lens. If you don't have any action camera and want both a 360 camera and a regular action camera, then this is literally made for you, and you shouldn't even hesitate to buy one. Preferably through my links in the description, please. But if you already have a GoPro Hero 7 or newer, then this is not for you. The Insta360 ONE X2 is still the best standalone 360 camera that you can possibly get. And if you pair that with a GoPro, you'll have the perfect team, but for twice the price.
But anyway, hit the like button if this video helped you make your mind up, and I'll see you on the next ride.